What is good, guys? We are here with Seal vs. Kick-Ass for Smoke Juice Playoffs. Seal bought Arachnid, which is interesting. Like, it's a good Kalia check in this game, I guess. Yeah, it is. It can get burned. It just resists both stabs. And we see Kick-Ass are bringing a Pinsir Magnezone team. There's not really a Skarmory or anything that the Magnezone can trap in this game. Let me just check my settings real quick. I'm not trying to like... Yeah, it should be fine. I'm not trying to be too loud, I'm not trying to be too low. I hope it's fine. I assume this is gonna be Protein Greninja. With Spikes, yeah, and Rocks Lando. It could be offensive Lando with Rocks to like get Rocks up to pressure like stuff like Sableye. With enough attack investment you 2-hit KO Sableye. Or just with Z-move in general, you can scare stuff on stall. Like, you can beat Skarmory down with a Continental Crush. And if you can get Rocks up, it could also be Rocks Mawile, and Landorus could just be offensive. Yeah, it could be like either double dance Landorus, or just another way of some sort of offensive Landorus. And if it's not Scarf Greninja, yeah, the team has a Zygarde to check Volcarona. So it doesn't have to be Scarf Greninja, it could be Scarf Tapu Lele. But as the HPI's Volcarona is looking super scary to this team. I guess Arachnid checks Volcarona too. Yeah, Arachnid checks Volcarona, what the fuck? I don't know how much equivalence plus one Z-move would do. Cause like Arachnid has Goat Spadev. Okay, that 580. I assume that's like HP invested Magnezone. And pretty sure that Kick-Ass will get up with Rocks here. Data Arachnid. It has 132 Spadef, so if it's like max HP or Spadef invested or something, it can potentially take a Z-move from Volcarona. Like, Inferno Overdrive is not that common at the moment anyway, I don't think. I think Charlie Berry has picked up in usage. I don't know how the ladder, just know in tour games it's been used a few times. So yeah, they both get up Rocks and Kick-Ass like U-turns out. Gets the free switch into Keldeo Latios, or if he specs, he can go into Tapu Lele. He's either Scarf Latios, Scarf Keldeo on this team, I would say. Tapu Lele is gonna be either like Shed Shield, Twisted Spoon, Specs, something like that. I don't think it would be Specs Lele. That doesn't make much sense to me on this team. Specs Lele would be, if he predicts correctly, is a pain to switch into. Like, it doesn't have a switch in, yeah, if he predicts correct. Like, Psychic blows Landorus away, but Hard Greninja is an option. Mawile never switches in on Tapu Lele, because it has, like, bad Spadef, and especially not at 46%. But even from full, it probably gets 2-hit KO'd from Specs, Lele, Psychic. Or at least from HP Fire, I don't know, from Psychic. Yeah, probably from Psychic too, because it's, like, terrain boost and stuff. Like, Specs for sure 2-hit KO'd. Like, I want to back it up with Calc because I don't want to say anything wrong. But I also don't want to miss a turn, but let me open the calculator real quick. So, like, if he wants to break the Psychic, he can go Hard Gren. But yeah, other than that, he can sack his Mawile. Landorus is still nice to check the Pinsir. But yeah, let me calc real quick. Tapu Lele. Choice Specs versus Mawile. Yeah, the calculator doesn't have the correct Mawile set, but like, it is a roll to 2-hit KO if it's max Spadef Mawile, this weird set from the Uber spread. If it's max HP Mawile, it's 62 to 73, and most Mawiles want a lot of speed. Like, they only run like 120 HP investment. Maybe a little bit more, maybe a little bit less, but they don't run max HP. But like, for Kick-Ass, it's just between if he's a choice mon. I can completely understand why he's taking so long. He doesn't want to let that Greninja come in on a potential psychic move. Landorus could take a Moonblast, but weakening Landorus is pretty nice for him, so I think I would click Moonblast here. Because, yeah, I think he's just exactly... He was either sacking the Mawile, or he was like... I don't think he would sack the Arachnid. That's still nice for the Keldeo. Who is higher ranked up, by the way? You can go to Greninja here, depending on the set. Like, if it's choice, Lily Greninja obviously comes in for free. But even if it's not choice, the Greninja outspeeds it for sure. The only thing... The only thing is what I meant, if it's Ash Ninja and the Lily is not choiced, you don't want to go into Greninja, because if the Lily is not choiced, Dark Pulse or Hydro Pump I don't think kills from 88. And then if the Lily changes that moves, you could get blown away if it's like Twisted Spoon. Which I think is still a possibility, yeah. I don't know if he's knockoff pins to get rid of Shedshell and Skarmory, that's an option. I assume that CL thinks this is choiced. The way he brings out his own Lily. The Magneson already took a huge hit, so I assume we're gonna see the Magneson sec from Kick-Asser here. Like, he doesn't really have a switch in, and so Magneson, seccing Magneson is just what makes the most sense to me. But yeah, I wanted to find out who was ranked higher and is able to pick. So CL was ranked higher, so he decided to play. I think the guy who's ranked higher gets to pick. He gets a Spatak drop. As we see, it's not choice Tapu Lily, it changes that moves from Psychic into Psy Shock. It did 41 to a Tapu Lily, its Protect Drop is a bit annoying. Yeah, but yeah, I want to calc if that's Twisted Spoon damage. Okay, so now he sacks out the Magnezone. So he basically decided to like take damage on Tapu Lily and to get some damage on the opposing Lily. But then he still stacked the Lily, the Magnezone. But yeah, if this is not Scarf Tapu Lily, Pinsir kinda gets a kill here. Cause Landorus doesn't carry Stone Edge anymore, it has to carry HP Eyes. And you can... Actually, Landorus... Landorus might be able to switch into Pinsir once, let me calc that real quick. Landorus Sirion... Like, we have rocks up, That's offensive Lando, let's say defensive Lando. The turn does 31 to 37. And with rocks up... And so Maxwell does 74. And with rocks up... yeah, he goes into Keldeo in case the Lily is Scarf. So this kind of confirms that it's Scarf Keldeo. Because like he has a Zygarde to check Volcarona, so he doesn't have to be Scarf Gwen like I said earlier. So this makes me think that he goes off this being Scarf killed and he doesn't want to risk his Pinsir. But yeah, the Pinsir wouldn't have been able to 2-hit KO the Landorus, I don't think. Unless he has lead on a switch, which is way too risky. Like on a potential switch. But yeah. The Araquanid can come in here, but the thing is, it has to take... I don't think Scald would kill the Tapu Lily, so I think he has to go for Hydro Pump here. He could also double on the Araquanid, which is a bit risky. Why did I say Tapu Lily? I meant to type Keldeo, or you choice Scarf. No, not whereas Araquanid, it does absolutely nothing. But how much does it do with the Tapu Lily? Scald is a roll to kill, so he has to go for Hydro Pump, yeah. Like, he needs a good roll to kill with Scald. So it's either Hydro Pump... I see, disconnected. It's either Hydro Pump... Or double into Pinsir, or something like that. Like, something that pressures the Araquanid. I think his Landorus showed rocks and U-turn, if I remember correctly. So that probably doesn't have Stone Edge or has anything to pressure Araquanid. Wait, what's CL warning when he comes back? Okay. We'll leave timer off. But yeah, I think he can't. I don't think he can afford to double here. Like a Hydro Pump only does like 20% to Araquanid. 20 to 24. But yeah, exactly. I don't think he could afford to double there. I think that was wrong English. But yeah, he makes the correct play. As like Araquanid still has to take rocks and pump does a good chunk, so I can understand that Seal didn't want to go hard Araquanid. If this is choice band, I think this is either choice band or AV. I think it's banded, honestly. And he's gonna click the liquidation here, cause like the only resist is the Latios. And if it's choice banded, I can calc how much it takes. Liquidation does 61 to 72 if it's choice banded, so it almost kills Lari. But yeah, he decides to stack off the Tapu Lele, which makes sense, as Tapu Lele wasn't doing much other than outspeeding Zygarde, potentially getting a hit off on Zygarde and outspeeding Landorus. Like, it basically lost to the Greninja, and he had to switch something in, and he didn't want to take Latios, let Latios take that huge hit, so I can understand that play. What did I want to call it again? I wanted to data someone, I forgot which one. Oh yeah, I wanted to see Tapu Lele. Just see the speed tiers. Oh yeah, Tapu Lele and Zygarde speed tie, but Zygarde tends to carry either the bandit set, which is adamant, and Lele likes to run timid sometimes, so Lele is faster most of the time, and there are also some Zygardes like to run the bulky spread with coil. I never really see Jolly Zygarde. Even on Dragon Dance I see Adamant. With the Dragon Dance Z-move set, I've seen that a few times. That is cool. You need like two Dragon Dances, so like then you're at plus one, and then you can Oko. You can Oko the Landorus with a Z-move at plus one. He goes to Pinsir here. He kinda needs this Araquanid to check the Keldeo, even though with rocks up he can only come in once on the Keldeo. So I think he's gonna SD break in the Landorus is what I was trying to say, because like there's no way that he takes this Keldeo check. But he didn't risk it. Oh, that did more than I thought it would. That did 49. Oh, because he had Hypercutter, yeah, okay. I was calculating with Intimidate earlier. So like almost every Pinsir runs Hypercutter. It's definitely a great ability because Landorus is like one of the common switches to Pinsir, and with Hypercutter you don't get the Intimidate drop. And yeah, if he SD'd that, didn't make a difference. I just forgot about Hypercutter then. Like that was this play that made a lot of sense. It was just like, if he SD's and gets Intimidated, he can maybe kill the Landorus at plus one. Because I think a plus one return would do more than two minus one returns. But maybe I'm mistaken there. But yeah, this is probably switch into Keldeo here. As he, okay, just go for Dark Pulse. Yeah, the Pinsir would have died to rocks, but I'm not sure if it was the right play to give him the Ash form. He should still kick Ether, should still be okay, but it's gonna be a close game. I assume it's gonna click Secret Sword, because Araquanid has worse defense than Spidef. And Greninja obviously lives the water move and would do like a good chunk, but he's definitely saving the Greninja, I think, for the Landor. But yeah, I don't think he can go Araquanid here, because he would get 2-hit KO'd. Choice Scarf, Secret Sword does 21 to 25. And he's at 76, so after rocks he had 51. So yeah, like, he doesn't get 2-hit KO'd, but still not sure if he wants to go hard Araquanid. Yeah, but Secret Sword does more in every case, even in Hydro Pump. So he's either sacking, wait, how much does it do to Zygarde? Let's say he's offensive Zygarde. Let's say Dragon Dance, because the Kalk doesn't have a bandit spread. So he can start a 33 to 38. That does nothing. So if he believes the Secret Sword, he could have gone to Zygarde, but he got a crit. So yeah, if Ziel would have switched into Zygarde there, he might have gotten 2-hit KO'd because of that crit. Yeah, he deceived again. I might have gone Zygarde there. Because, like, the Secret Sword, I think it was forced to Secret Sword. Like, just that it kills the Greninja, like I said, and it does more to Arachnid than the water move anyway. So I don't really see the point in... Like, I don't think he was ever clicking Icy Wind, or he was never clicking Icy Wind or Hydro Pump there. Like, even Icy Wind is not that common, but it's ran sometimes. But he was never clicking anything in Secret Sword there, I don't think. So he could have gone Zygarde, but the crit would have sucked. The crit would have done how much? Like, this is just me going off offensive Zygarde. If it's bulky Zygarde, it would have done even less. I would have done 49 to 58. So the Zygarde would have been at like 40 something. It could have still lived another one and then... Yeah, but Kick-Ass is still at the learners to check it, so I can understand the play. He gets a kill, he would ban it liquidation. It kills him even with Intimidate, so... Dang. But yeah, now the Arachnid is so low that the Laddie can... Like, he's forced to sack it. Like, he's forced to sack the Arachnid. And if it's Scarf Latios... And Psyshock doesn't 2-hit KO the Zygarde. CL can win here if he Dragon Dances twice. Yeah, CL actually wins if he's DD and DDs twice, I think. Like, if he's able to take two Psyshocks, let us calc real quick. Oh, it's not Scarf Latios, never mind. I think it's Life Orb then or Z-Move. Yeah, it's probably Z-Move. Soldo or Z-Move, yeah. We haven't seen a Z-Move on his team. Yeah, I think he's gonna go for Z-Move and blow this away, unless he's the Z-Thunder Bolt. It could be Z-Psychic, Z-Thunder Bolt, Z-Thunder, whatever. I don't think he's Devastating Drag, so he probably has to rely on a Draco Meteor to hit here. Like, either Z-Move or Soldo, like I said, I don't think he's choiced. Yeah, Specs is another set that has been used a bit. Specs is another option. But Specs also keeps the Zygarde in check. Because Specs Psyshock would do so much damage that Kelly would definitely revenge this with Scald or Hydro Pump. Maybe not with Scald, but with Hydro Pump for sure. Like... Let's say Life Orb Psyshock does 40 to 48. And Specs would do even more. We do see this Choice Garf Zygarde. SCL pulls that out of nowhere. What the fuck? Where did he get Choice Garf Zygarde from? Yeah, I'm not calking on the last turn. We're just gonna see. Kelly is gonna be faster. And CL might have, not CL, Kick-Ass might have changed up the names on the last turns, I'm not sure. But yeah, Kick-Ass might have to hope for a Scald Burn here. Because I don't think he can Oko this. Even if he has Icy Wind, which he probably doesn't have. Actually, he might have Icy Wind. He does have Icy Wind, but I don't think it kills. Yeah, I don't think it kills. And if this Outrage kills, CL wins. Oh, okay, that was a snag for the Keldeo. So he has to hit this Icy Wind and he wins. Kick-Ass wins Sun and Moon. That was a close game. And he misses! Oh my god, he can still hit himself in confusion. He doesn't hit himself in confusion. Get me out of here! Oh my lord. So CL wins because of an Icy Wind miss. Dude, I was about to say it can still miss. This is not 100% accuracy. It's like 95 or something. Data Icy Wind. And he still said GG then. That's a good sport. Damn, this game come close. Holy flip. 95 accuracy, 55 power. Yeah, I assume that Kick-Ass I can pick now. I assume he's gonna pick Aura, as we will see. I don't know how good he is in black and white. I think CL is better in black and white than Auras. But yeah, I'm gonna pause it and actually not gonna pause it. I'm gonna upload the next game after. So stay tuned for game 2. Oh my lord, what an ending. Holy flip.